not because concern, but because I'm not math teacher. Although we have many math subjects, I was not very good at it. But but there is something in common which the thing that common in math and comp sci, which I found interesting originally, is logic. Diba? Marami kayo, meron kayo predicate, calculus, something. Alam niyo ba yun? Comp sci? So you know logic, but before that, I want to, so it's a but since everybody also is using a computer, you can quite relate to everything, most things in a computer. So anyway, the computer is actually a computing machine, right? It computes, so it's mathematical also. So I was comparing something. I was comparing computers like this one, humans like us, and God. But how? How? Ganto. So, for example, when a baby is born, there are built-in functions he can do. Like what? Cry. So when a computer is also brand new, lalo na yung computer na mura lang, parang OS. Meron yung built-in function. Anong built-in function? It's called the BIOS, di ba? Basic Input-Output System. Yung magubot siya. Ang wala kang magagawa, setup lang. Yun yan. And then you have to teach the computer new things, right? Like installing. That's how you educate the computer or the baby. You have to teach it. But the baby is more smart. It's just observing. And it is from the reception in the senses, it is learning. And then, so the baby learns in the senses, the computer is enabled to do tasks by teaching it or programming. So teaching humans is programming. When you teach people, they are downloading from you. The baby can sleep and wake up. Of course, computer also can sleep. You know, you can close your computer and sleep. It consumes less energy. And when you turn it on, it wakes up. But sometimes when you shut it down, it takes time. Diba? You know, it takes time, especially if you have many drivers. When you turn on, it takes some time to wake up. You cannot type immediately. Also, when you wake up, you cannot actually start immediately because you know, it's now a machine for ground, while missing. You know, so, do not joke. You can joke a drunk man, but not somebody who just woke up. Even Proverbs says, he who greets his neighbor in the early in the morning will be taken as a curse. So, there is a boot time. You know, when you wake up, you have to take time to boot up. Computers have a booting process. You know, booting process when you turn your computer. It came from the, just in case you don't know, it came from the word boots during the time of the cowboys. You are not a cowboy if you have not no boots. When you put on your boots, then you are a cowboy now. So that's the booting process. And this is the thing. Our awareness of the computer's operation is incomparable to the computer's awareness of our operation. Sir, does the computer understand us? No. All it does is loops while if some data blah blah blah. But does it understand even our emotions? It can pretend. We can program it to pretend. But it's really simple, right? We humans, we don't even understand ourselves. Diba? We are complicated, but we created computers, and therefore the computer we created is simpler than the one who created it, right? In relation to that, God who created us is more complicated than us, the creation. Diba? If the computer cannot explain us, but at least the computer knows there's a problem, maybe there's a break, the Pasamba problem. But you know, us, we cannot really understand God, because God is more complicated, more big. The Creator is always bigger than the creature. And we can understand that, especially the concept. When you make programs, you are exerting your creative power. But sometimes we can program the computer to be intelligent enough to control itself for some time. However, it cannot survive for a long time without the creator, di ba? Ano doba? Or magkakabayos? Or the electric fan will be plugged with dust, and it has, it still needs always the creator, di ba? You try to run unlicensed Windows, can you update?
Sir,
ha?
Sir, you're happy by yourself.
Yes, we will touch that later. Also, in humans, we cannot exist without our creator for long, right? We cannot exist long. In fact, we are all supposed to die after about 70 years. But the creator can restart or can replace the hardware. The software is safe. But the hardware can be replaced. Yeah, no, software updates. However, our computer, it needs to update because of our errors, program errors. But us, we update because of our errors, not because of God's error, because God created humans perfect. But sin destroyed. Hindi sinasabi niya na? Virus, sin. Okay, from time to time, so creator, God said, let us create man in our own image, in Genesis. But we people who make computers, we want artificial intelligence. We want the computer to play chess with us. We want the computer to act like us, to look like us, to see like us, to move like us, to do the things we are born to do. Like factories, making bread, making cars, etc. So there is different purpose. But that creative ability and that creative drive is because God also is a creator. He wants to create. Creating for God is something nice. He likes to do it. He created so many things. And us, creative people, especially yung mga kumsay na creative, hindi nyo namitilinan lang. You like to program even if there is no assignment, right? How about the will? When a programmer works on a computer, he is expressing his will to it. When you make a program, include, make, printf, that is your will, right? And the computer is sensible only if it follows your will. If you say, echo hello world, and the computer says, echo hi, it's not good computer, right? It should obey the creator, right? Doesn't make sense. Also, us, when God says, thou shalt not steal, and then we steal. Oh, that's a good creator, right? So God has instructions. God lets us know his will to us, so that we can follow the instructions. If we are not following the instructions, it's called error. Yeah, error. And if there is an error, the computer will make an error message, right? It is confessing, I did an error. So as also, when we make an error, we have to tell God there is an error. You fix me, you fix me, you have to fix me. So the nice thing is, the creator is concerned with his creature. And can fix. How about intelligence? We try to make the computer as intelligent as we can make them. Yeah, programming. That's why we are doing AI. But they are always stupider than us. Or they are always inferior than us. We cannot explain ourselves. You know why we cannot program a computer as good as ours? Because we cannot explain ourselves. If we can understand ourselves, we can communicate to the computer. So in areas where we understand ourselves by thinking, we can make the computer better than us. But since we don't understand the quality of the human mind, we can never create a computer that is fully better than the creator. But God was more successful because he created in the image. Okay, how about differences? Why are some computers different from each other? Many humans, we are all different. But we are the same, but we are different, right? Are you from different, what is that, evolution? Why some here is strong, some here is... But there is different, there is difference, right? So, when we make computers, lalo na yung Apple, pare-pareho, di ba? But yung PC, they are all different. Acer, Toshiba, they are all different, but they are all the same also. Because we like to manage best differences. Need the drivers, need the lightings, okay. But there is also difference, because when God gave talents, some people are good in math, some people are good in home science, some people are good in singing, some people are good in game, you know, game. How about crafters? Yan yung sinasabi ni, ano pa rin yan? Yeah. Computers exist for good purposes, but there are bad people with bad goals. They use it for bad goals. When good and bad interests are present, computer its purpose is confused. So you don't know if the computer has virus or not. When you type your password, it's memorizing your password and sending your password to the hacker. But if you have a virus, well, somebody crack. You know, sabinya, somebody crack. Somebody is hacking. That's why somebody wants to install their own software called SIM in humans. God said, do not eat. Say that, say that. So Satan has some hidden achievement and he's trying to do.
Sir.
Your computer cannot save itself.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, yung pong hacking, kinukuha niya yung product mo, dapat kumbi ka na sa sarili mo product.
Tama, yes. You can percentage that because you know, not everybody can. Okay, not everybody is rich, but we will help them. We will provide solution first and then tell the problem, right? It's easier than tell the problem and then no solution, so we ask stress. Okay. So the computer cannot save itself. If there is virus, you think it can fix itself? No, you need the programmer or the reinstaller, somebody bigger than the computer. Us also, because of sin, we cannot save ourselves. We are already fallen. We need the manufacturer. We need warranty. Warranty. Lifetime warranty. But if you don't go back to the store, there is no warranty. It will expire. There is close of probation.
Okay.
So, how about forgiveness and sin? We've done that already. How about predestination? This one is very hard. If God knows everything, why does He allow suffering? Diba? Diba? Okay, have you ever thought of that? How can you reconcile a God who knows everything and suffering? Or how? Let's go through it now, because if we can understand that, we can compare it with people who make computers. If Jerome knows all the possible things in his program, how come his program has errors sometimes? How come he allows? It's very hard to explain, huh? In computer. I will just change the explanation. I'm sorry, there's an easy explanation for computer to compare. But there's an easy explanation for classroom. You know what? For example, I will teach you what's the easiest subject. Intro to computer. I know the lesson, right? Book from cover to cover. And even the things that are not inside the cover. But the students, they don't know. I'm going to teach them, my goal is to get everybody in. Right? I will teach them the whole set. I will tell them to study the whole set. But there are still possibilities. A, A minus, B plus, D, until F. I want everybody to get A. I teach everybody to get A. I give them the book, but not everybody decides to study. Therefore, there is the freedom of choice. Are you going to believe the teacher or not? So, I as a teacher, I know that some people are going to get A, some people are going to get F. I know all the possibilities, right? Why am I allowing people to get F? Because they don't want to study. I want all of them to get A. I give them everything, my time, my attention, tutorial, the resources, assignment, quiz, just to get ready. But some people are playing games and watching movies. Therefore, their choice will have a result. That is not my will, right? So that's what how we will reconcile. In humans, God wants us all to be saved, but we have a choice if we believe or not, right? Okay, finish. How about evolution? Evolution. Can you make a computer program that creates itself? Yes. That's called reproduction. That's not evolution. Very easy. In the internet, there is a program that runs and it makes a program the same as itself. In a 3D printer, there is a 3D printer that prints itself. It can print another 3D printer and you assemble it. It's the same 3D printer. So it's reproduction. That one is no problem. But can the 3D printer create something more complicated than itself? Or can your program, self-reproducing program or virus, can create more complicated, hello world, more complicated virus? Oh, I was asking in my AI class last time, they said it's not possible. Therefore, evolution is not possible, right? You have to have intelligent critical, right? Okay, and you randomize. Randomize all the letters in the keyboard. Maybe after millions of years, you will come up with Windows. One day, no? How about millions of years? You cannot prove because we are going to die 70 years old, right? How about socialization? The back computers are all network now. And the more the computer is the network. If the Google server number 1000 doesn't know the answer, maybe Google server number 2000 knows the answer, right? So networking makes the collective intelligence. Also as humans, we are friends with many smart people. So if you don't know, we ask. Okay, finish. Not cheating. There is a time to ask and a time to know. Okay, so God is very mysterious. Like us, a mystery to the computer. Ganyan. How about coding? Okay. Servers, there are so many things. Some people can do many talents, can serve many people. They are called servers. Some people don't know. They are clients. But when you already are mature, you become more a server, right? You serve more people. You provide services and you get money from the services. Okay. Multitasking, of course, the computer just has only one mind, one processor, or maybe five, or how many cores, but there is multitasking, one code can do so many things. And balancing and priorities. Rest. How about rest? Does the computer keep the Sabbath? Should your computer keep the Sabbath?
Yung memory po niya, sir, nagbubura. Yung RAM nagbubura pagpatay.
Oo nga. Kaya kailangan creator yan. How about the rest? This is a question for your computer people. Will your servers rest on Sabbath?
Yes.
My answer is, depends on what the creator said. I'm the creator of the computer. It's my decision whether I want it to rest or not. But God is the creator of humans. When God says you rest, you rest. If not, then not. You are not following the program correctly, right? So if I create a cell phone and I say you should reboot it every now and then, do it. You have to follow the creator, right? How about miracles? What if you don't understand things? But they happen. They are called miracles. If you understand things that they happen, they are just not miracles, right? So there are natural things that happen that are beyond our comprehension. We call them miracles. Diba? Correct? Is the rainbow a miracle? No. We can make a rainbow with a hose. Is the rainbow a sign? Yes. The world will not be fully flooded again. Right? What else? No more. Okay. So there are many nice things that are the same, that which can help us understand God more and help us understand computers more. What is happening? But logic is the thing that mathematics understands and clocks I understand. What is logic? It is the science of correct thinking, diba? According to my teacher before. So if you are thinking correctly, we call you are logical, right? If you are not thinking correctly, this guy is illogical. He's more emotional than logical. He's illogical, yeah? Like that. So the science of correct thinking. And in logic, especially if you are a judge, you have to consider both. For example, I hear Jigdaw, Jigbud. That's positive, affirmative. Yeah, that's the assertion, that is the proposition. Now, propositions can be either true or false. Right? You cannot say, I heard, therefore he is. No, that's not logical. You have to consider both. You have to ask that the other side. Is it true that J is cheekbone? So you weigh. You cannot push somebody to the death penalty without considering both. Because you have to be logical. So if you hear something and you cannot verify, you cannot conclude. Do not conclude if you did not consider both sides. So logical is considering the affirmative and the negative, not only one side. Well, what is an algorithm? A An algorithm, everyone knows algorithms are, of course everybody knows algorithm. It is a correct way of solving a problem, right? There is an algorithm.
Formula.
A formula. The mathematicians understand formula a little bit more. A correct way, but there are many correct ways, right? There is a shorter way, there is a long cut way, there is a brute force way, there is etc. way. What is a problem now? Okay, a problem is something that gives you. For example, we make a program to manage the direction of the rocket. And then there is a bomb. Of course, boom. If it explodes, the astronauts will die. Right? So that's a problem. If it kills somebody, it's a problem. What else? It's a definition of problem. Something that causes a lot of loss. For example, you are trading, you know, mathematicians, you are very smart. When you program a computer which can do at patterns in the stock market, you can find patterns and buy when it's cheap and sell when it's expensive. And one of the richest people, mathematicians, are the ones who first programmed those algorithms. While they are sleeping, their program is selling and buying and making money for them. Right? So, but if there is a bug in the program, nako, it will also make you lose a lot of money. Like something that happened in the stock market some time ago. But in more in the mathematician world, a problem is something that has to be proven. Something that has to be known. Find X. Where is your X now? Can't find. Now we have the internet, find your X. He's gone already. So there is a solution. If there's a problem, there is a solution. No, what is a solution? Okay. You know, the solution is steps. It's like an algorithm. We study this in software engineering, in making term papers, and in other ways of solving problems. First, you have to identify the problem, right? If you don't understand the problem, how can you solve it? That's why there are many problems in real life. I wish I was smarter. I cannot solve it with programming because I don't understand the problem. And then you find solutions. You evaluate. We have this option, this option, this option, this option. Which one is cheaper? Which one is takes less time? Which one takes less hassle, etc. And design solutions. And then you have to execute the solution. Or you program now. We do this one, you program, we implement, and then you have to test. Oh, testing is very, very important. That's why you make it much. You see, you check if the answer is the same, right? Test, and then you propagate. This is where you make money, then you sell the windows. You sell, because it solves solutions. It solves problems, and then you maintain, or you keep working, you keep updated on new problems and new solutions. Yeah? So what is a program? A program is a written algorithm. It has problems also sometimes. The problems come from wrong data, wrong logic, hardware error, misunderstood protocol, misunderstood requirements, and if you don't understand the problem. My question is, what is the biggest problem in the world? The biggest problem is there is a storm coming. The storm coming might kill people. When people die, they will either go to hell or heaven. But there is a solution. You have to tell them, right? And there is the storm is only a warning of the more storms that are coming in the future. Right? So we have to know the problem. Problem is nobody wants to die. Nobody wants to die in the storm. The algorithm is the plan of salvation. This is the problem sin. The solution is Jesus Christ. And you repent, and then you surrender, you follow. Oh. So that's the solution. But there are problems. How come some people don't get the salvation correctly? Because there is bad data. They heard the solution not from the Bible, from bad data, bad source. Sometimes they didn't understand the logic. They thought works and love are, they didn't understand correctly. Sometimes there is a hardware error, or they cannot think properly. You ate too much monosodium glutamate, you delete your brain cells, and you cannot think properly. By the way, do you know that MSG kills brain cells? Maybe you are smart, so you have many remaining. So don't do that in the Europe, if you do this, and you look at the or junk food, you look at the label, there's MSG. It makes the food tasty, but it kills your brain cells, according to National Institute of Health. So, it kills brain cells of rats. Of course, you cannot test your brain cells. But it also happens, you know, when you eat the MSG, we have headache, but we sleep and we wake up and we get it. But a lot of you have a lot of brain cells, but me, I don't know the MSG. Because I have only few. I want to conserve. The nice thing, before in the 1980s, scientists said that brain cells do not regenerate. When they get deleted, they are deleted forever. But it's not true. They found out later that brain cells regenerate. So if you eat MSG and some brain cells get deleted, lice, NYS, after some days or weeks, they will be replaced with new ones, brand new brain cells. The problem is, they are newly formatted, no data, no connections. So you are going to study your lesson until you memorize and then you get MSG and then there is disconnection. No more solution. You have to study again, you forgot, right? So there is a way to minimize the damage. Put vitamin C in your body. Now we are studying computer hardware of humans. Okay, now let me give you a big problem. Let me see, let me test your logic. Let me test your logic. This one. There is a logic. No, it's not your problem. So it's easier to solve somebody else's problem, right? Because you are not emotional. You are not emotionally. There's no problem. But your problem you don't give it much face, right? So let's try to solve somebody else's problem. This is the problem. Please. But before I tell you the problem, I want to show you something. I want to show you something. Do you see it? Do you know what that is? This is a
rainbow.
It's not a rainbow. This is Genesis to Revelation. Because we have a computer science club, linkers club. This is Genesis to Revelation. This is God's program, by the way. It's program from creation until restoration, right? In heaven, from glory, no sin, until glory, no more sin again. Amen. Revelation 22. These rainbows are links. You know, hyperlinking, internet are links, right? In the Bible, there are also links. Revelation talks about something here. Genesis talks about something there. There. You see, you imagine, the Bible was written, I think, 1,600 years span, with many people not knowing each other. But there are so many links that confirms each other. You cannot believe only the New Testament. I only believe the New Testament because I'm young. All people believe the Old Testament. Because in the New Testament, Jesus says, according to Moses, like this. According to David, like this. According to, like this, like this. So those are links going back. So you cannot believe only half. Because the half will also say that the other is true. And this is really amazing, right? It's a very long historical book. Cyrus, he was Cyrus to attack that city. He was prophesied to rain. And he knows, the name, even the name is mentioned. This only proves, friends, that there is a program running. There is a program running. History is the CPU. The CPU is executing commands according to the program, according to the if statement. If Jerome doesn't repent, he's going here. If he repents, he's going there. So there are if, multiple transfers going. So if you want to know the program of the world, ayan, then your program. Okay, now, the problem, the people who are not going to finish the program properly, there is a not correct thinking. Their CPU is not working properly, right? Because You know you are going to die, but you still jump. How come? Yeah, you can, right? You know the storm is coming, you didn't have to hide. You are there in the, under the coconut, so the coconut follows you. Right? So there are warnings over here, warnings of things to come. So the logical thing to do, if you are logical, mathematical, computer science, logical, is to know the data, know what is coming, and pattern yourself according to how you want, where you want to go. Okay. I'll give you an example. You know, this is an academic. This is not a pulpit. This is an academic exercise. Therefore, we can talk about things that are not that are not so easy. Okay. I will give you a very hard problem. You don't have to solve it. I will just teach you. Can Seventh-day Adventists cook on Sabbath?
Yes.
Wait. Who can say yes without getting data? You have to get data from where? From the Bible, from the Scripture of Prophecy, from the Church Adventist Gospel, right? No. But the data comes from the Bible, right? Not from practices. We are not a church that gets our theology from practices. There are other denominations to do that. Because we practice, therefore, like this. We're not like that. We are looking in the Bible. If we find ourselves wrong, we correct ourselves, right? Because only the Bible is sure. Humans, they change, they die. So even the fraternities, they will all die. So why are we here, right? But the Bible is always there. No heaven and earth shall pass away. The world will remain. Okay, so the most stable thing is the Bible. If you want to know the truth, you want to run your program with correct data, the Bible. Okay, does the Bible allow cooking on Sabbath? Yes, no. No. When the manna came, God told, by the way, who told no cooking on Sabbath? Is it the Pharisee? Is it Moses? Or is it God who told Moses? God who told Moses. Don't worry about what you are doing. So we are just exercising logic, right? Don't worry about what you are doing first. Let's pretend you don't know. Anyway, God forgives if you don't know. But now we are going to know. Okay, the Bible says, no cooking, right? God said, I will give you manna, seed what I will seed, cook what I will cook. And in the seventh day, do not go to the cafeteria, right? Do not go to collect food. So I'm just telling you historically what happened. Okay. How about now? Some people may say, oh, you know, that was before, because before it's hard to cook. Let's see, you know, the Bible is very hard to understand, and our minds is very polluted. That there are 45,000 Christian denominations who claim to believe the Bible. How can you have 45,000 understanding when there is only one source? Right? So as a Adventist, we like to affirm our understanding from the Spirit of Prophecy, from the prophet who is the most recent, who has the most writings. What does he say? Oh, those who cook on the Sabbath by the fourth man. Cook, really, this is data. Okay, really? Maybe it changed. How about the church document? Says, Adventist does not, but this is data now, right? Buying and preparation of food, ready of clothes and other necessities should be completed before sundown, Friday. Cook? Adventist does not. Really? How about buying and preparation, including microwave and, you know, is it cooking? Okay, so, here's your data. Now the question is, how about my, I don't know, let's not discuss about something that is near to our heart. How about my neighbor? Why is he cooking? Maybe you don't know, right? You don't have data, right? You don't have data. So, the solution is to, what is the solution? What is hard? You just, let's look for solution. Let's look for solution. Because now we are stressed, right? We are stressed now. Now there is a solution, by the way. Because I know you want to obey, but you don't know how, right? You want to obey, but you don't know how. The nice thing, there are many people, I discovered, I collected more data, who know how? Demonstration. Very easy. For example, Mongkar. They cook their bayan before Sabah, according to the president. I heard this at IAS. Second, Pastor Sinaga, SSD. She said, he agreed that preparation should be done before, according to the website. Okay. Number three, I have a teacher. After she retired, she became missionary in some island. She said, let's try to follow. So they had no electricity, they took their food, they cook on Friday, they put under the ground. After some in Sabbath, it's still warm. Oh, really? And then somebody was preaching for Kahoy. He said, you know, my grandparents, they know how to do that. Really? How come we don't know? Because we forgot. So I thought, nobody is teaching them in Philippines. But I found out from this guy, his grandparents were doing it. So it was not by the missionaries in the Philippines. How come we don't know? Because we forgot. But the nice thing, the fourth commandment is remember. Oh, God knows that we will forget. So it's remember, remember. So we are not remembering the data. So that we can think and behave logically, right? It's logical, right? But emotion is very hard. Because you know, emotion is lagging, it's late. In our house, my mom almost is perfect. Almost. Most things, but sometimes they are coming late. Oh, here in the UP, they said they can cook if there is big rain. Oh. And then there in missionary, there in the Ilocos, they do not cook on Sabbath. Very good. So also, somebody in Putikahoy said, my parents, my uncle used to do this. They give dayami, rice. So another person in the internet said, yes, we are doing it. And then another person says, if you don't like to cook, don't eat. Just fasting. Nice solution, right? Another is Ryan Hennes says they eat only fruits and vegetables. And then one more somebody says they put palayis around the caldero and wrap it so that it stay warm. And then somebody says, if cooking for many people, a ref is needed so the food will not spoil. And that's why in other church, even washing dishes, they don't, they're not supposed to wash dishes. That's why sometimes they use the paper. Diba? What he says, don't wash dishes. So me, I don't wash dishes. I only wash dish. Only mine. Just joking. But there is another, okay. And there is another one who chat me. You know, there is more data. The more data you have, the more sure you are that is true. Right? You have to investigate the positive and the negative. And somebody messaged me, they said, their elder or their father, 20% of the church, don't cook on Sabbath. In some other church, wow. And some people say, they just eat kamote. Anyway, when they cook kamote, they take it from the rest. And they reach the church in the noon. The kamote is not cold anymore, so they just eat. No need to eat, right? And then there is another one, there is even catering. Who knows how to not who avoid food on Sabbath? There is a businessman who is very rich, not very rich, a little bit rich only. He says he can even avoid taking a bath. But he stays in his airport room. Then there is still, you know, this is life is a program. If you run your life from correct data, you will have a nice mirage. But if your data is wrong, your algorithm, you lose money, you lose even your life. Okay? So we try to collect data because the most important program is the program you are running. So also, okay, there is more data. Okay, now we know there is a difference between what's supposed to be fitness and logic, right? But you know, logic, we have to depend on big data. You don't ask this one, because that guy is just commenting opinion. You ask where is it written. I tried to look where is it written that we are terminating moving, I cannot find it. Okay, that's one example of logic. You know, one of the people, researchers in Biblical Research Institute is a computer science person, Winter Wallin. Before he became a Christian, he was a computer scientist. And he studied languages, and he studied theology. Now, He is chair. And he was my boss before. In IAS, he was teaching IAS in Greek. He made the first online Greek class. So the logic, right? We have to be logical. Doesn't mean, you know, when we take calculus, that's already logical. You have to apply logic to our life. Okay, what's next? There is another test here. Maybe it's too much already. Yan, tupa. Ah, this one is very nice. You will have fun with this. If you like logic, you will like this. Yan, another controversy. You know, we look for problems and we try to use correct thinking, right? If we try to solve things that are not done, what for? It's boring. So, let's see. This is a big discussion now. But we will try to use a logic. Some people want to ordain women. What's the logic? They said because the Bible says, does not say do not. Oh, really? Is that how it's supposed? But my logic is like this. Does the Bible also say, do not baptize infants? Does the Bible say, do not baptize infants? Does the Bible doesn't say, do not baptize infants, right? Does the Bible say, do not baptize springly? No. Why don't we do it? Because the Bible doesn't say that we should do it. But, so if your theology is loose, you will do everything the Bible does not say, do not. But if you want a tight theology, tight logic, you will only do things that is according. Sure, the Bible promotes advertises. Because according to Isaiah 8:20, if they speak not according to His word, there is no life in them. You know what according means? According means true, for example. This one, you need your logic to understand this. All right, after my lecture, I say I'm going to Iolis. According to me, I'm going to Iolis after the lecture, right? And then maybe JR says, you know, Sermin is going to administration after his lecture. My question is it contradictory or not? Okay, you will be divided. Some say yes, some say no. No problem. My question is it according to me or not? No, you are unsure it's not according, right? Okay, correct, right? So if you are only thinking of non-contradiction, you are confused. You don't know which is true. But if you want to be sure, you are according, you are sure, right? So the question is, does the Bible say do not baptize infants? No. That means it's not according. But that's not the problem. We have to be tight. The tightness of our logic is that it has to be according. So everything we do, everything we teach, is supposed to be according. There is positive. Right? Okay. For example, does the Bible say, do not transfer the sanctity of the Sabbath to Sunday? Can you find the Bible verse? Do not transfer to Sunday. Do not transfer to Friday. Do not transfer to Thursday. There is no Bible verse. But why don't we transfer? The Bible says, does not say do not transfer, because the Bible says keep the Sabbath. That's why the Bible says yes, that's it, right? So, accordingness is more tight than non-prohibition. But some people lack logic, or they did not think properly. They want to do everything that the Bible does not prohibit. That's very loose. That's not our understanding. For example, another example, does the Bible say you cannot convert your tithe to only 5%? Diba? The Bible doesn't say I cannot give 1% tithe only. But if you want accordingness, tithe is 10%, a tenth of your goods, right? So accordingness is the strictest, most square logic of understanding. For example, does the Bible also say that the dead do not go to purgatory? Does the Bible say that the dead, when you die, you will not go to purgatory? You will not. You are looking for everything, not that, no? But that's not the most strict, most sure. But the Bible says when you die, you don't know anything. So that is how strict our logic is on these things. Now let us go. That is just a mental exercise of logic. There is another idea History is data. I was teaching, I was showing how we look at graph. Diba, history are things that happen. You know them already. They are in history books. That's data, because we have data. This happened, this happened. Future is a projection. For example, you made 1,000 last month, last yesterday, the other day 1,000, the other day 1,000, the other day 1,000 pesos. You can predict, after 1 month, next tomorrow, probably you're going to make 1,000, 1,000, 1,000. Right? So that is a projection. We don't know, but we can project, right? So data is existing already, but projection is future. But there is what we call a function. If something is growing, for example, it is linear, you are adding 1,000 per day. Right? That's linear, right? Until you get 100,000, 1 million. You are adding 1,000 per day in your bank account. After 30 days, you project in a linear graph that you have 30,000, right? That's linear. So the function is like prophecy. In the Bible, it's like prophecy. How do you know? You know the pattern. You will look at history first. Babylon, Medo-Persia, Greece, Rome. Oh, history followed Bible prophecy. Therefore, the next one is God's kingdom. Oh. So the function, you don't know the future, but the function you see from history, you can see the future because you look at the pattern. Okay, it's very hard. I think you are already, your hard disk is full already. Another one, your faith. Last thing. Sabi sa 2 Corinthians 5:7, believe by faith, not by sight. We don't know the future, but we know the function. And we know what is going to happen. We know the result, right? If you give this X, this result will come out with the function. Because you already know the pattern. And dito magagaling yung mama. This is where we concise, we are jealous about the math majors. Because you can find patterns, on, especially on numbers, right? You see a sequence of numbers, this, like the play a while ago. And you, after enough samples, you see the pattern and you can now predict what is going to happen in the future. Right? So, that is faith. You don't know, but because you know the previous, not by sight, but by faith, because you know the pattern. So, also in real life, we have to study history so that you will know the pattern that is going in the future, right, Dominic? So, that is the end of my notes. To summarize, the universe is a computer. According to Sinanabel, the German computer scientist. The universe is a computer. But they don't know that they are not Christians. They don't know there is God. But at least they have an idea that the universe is a computer. But we know better. The universe is really a computer. It's not a digital computer. It's a biological computer. It has life. It runs a program. Who made the program? God, right? God is the great programmer. That's why Sir Vito was saying, when we reach heaven, we are going to ask about the API. What is the API for this one? Wait, sorry. API is Application Programming Interface. You want to know all the capabilities of a language, you read APIs, API. What are the functions available for math, what are the functions available for strings, etc. So, very nice. You will ask them, what is the pattern? How come you compress the whole human being into genes? How can you decompress? How can you find the pattern? How can the mango decompress in one seed? Then it grows up, it's still a mango, it's not a component. How do you compress? Compression is another algorithm. So that is the nice thing. The universe is a computer. It is running God's program. And the only way to correctly run it is to obey the program, right? Amen. So may you all be logical. May you all get data correctly from the source. Not from opinions of Jerome or other philosophers, but from the programmer. Because you know the philosopher has virus, right? Okay, so do we still have time?
45 minutes.
45 minutes, ha? Sige, may 10% pa ka naman, mas maganda.
Sige lang nga.
Next time. So, yun lang.